Welcome back to our channel where we're all about making your WordPress life a little easier and smarter. Now today we're going to show you the absolute best and easiest way to add annotations to Google Analytics for your WordPress site. And guess what? I've got a secret weapon up our sleeves, Monster Insights, the ultimate WordPress analytics plugin that'll make this process a breeze. And the best part? It's super easy, it's totally free, and you don't need a degree in rocket science, be a coder, or know how to use Google Tag Manager to make it happen. And you can see them right inside your WordPress dashboard. So, ready to become an annotation wizard? Great, let's get started. Step one is installing Monster Insights. And don't worry, it's easier than figuring out what you're going to have for dinner tonight. Now, for a full walkthrough of how to set up Monster Insights, just be sure to check out our guide on how to add Google Analytics to WordPress the right way, or see our light instructions to try it out first. I'll leave a link in the description. All right, once you have Monster Insights installed, you're ready to get started. Now let's move on to step two, adding a Google Analytics annotation. This is where the real fun begins. The first way to add a new site note and manage your annotation settings is in the Site Notes section. From your WordPress admin, click Insights, and then Site Notes. Here you'll see all the annotations that you've created. Now press the Add Site Note button to create a new one. Then fill in the title of your site note. Next, select a date, which can be any time in the past or the future, and choose a category. Now, if you're using Monster Insights Pro, you can also add media to your note. If you want the site note to be marked as important, just click the star under the title. Now, when you're finished, just make sure to click the Add Site Note at the bottom to save your annotation. Now, if you're using the Pro license or above, you have the option to click the Categories tab or Export tab at the top. Categories are super helpful for organizing your Google Analytics annotations with custom categories and colors. To create or edit a category, just click the Categories tab and press the Add New Category button. Fill in the category name and select the color, then click Add New Category again to save it. You'll immediately see your new annotation category in the drop-down list when you make or edit a site note. If you're using Monster Insights Pro, you can also click the Export tab at the top and a CSV of your site notes will be immediately downloaded. This is really helpful if you want to add your Google Analytics annotations to Looker Studio or another platform that accepts CSV data. Now, another way to add site notes is from your Monster Insights dashboard. So, on the admin sidebar, click on Insights. Now you'll see your traffic graph displayed, now along with other Google Analytics reports from your site. Now, just below the traffic graph, click Site Notes. Now the section is going to expand. So, if you've entered any annotations for the Google Analytics date range shown in the graph, well, they'll appear here. To add a note, click the blue Add New Site Note button. Next, fill out the details for your annotation, then choose a category, and you can also click the star to add the annotation to Important. For pro users, you can click Select Media to add an attachment to the note. When you're finished, click the Add Site Note button at the top to save your Google Analytics annotation. The new site note will immediately show up on the traffic graph above, as well as in the Site Notes section that we saw in the last step. All right, now let's take a look at the third way of adding Google Analytics annotations with site notes. One of the best things about site notes is that it can add a new annotation when you publish a new post, new page, or a new product. So you don't have to remember to manually add one in order to see how that content is affecting your traffic later. You can edit the details of your annotation right inside the post editor. Once you're in the WordPress editor, just look at the side menu. Then under Post on the right, you'll see that the Site Note section has been added. Find the option for Add a Site Note and toggle it on. It automatically includes the new post title as the annotation. If you don't want to create a side note for that content, well, just leave it toggled off. You can also edit the name of your annotation, change which category it's assigned to, and if you want to change the annotation, you can always do that in the Site Notes section of Monster Insights. And there you have it. Now you're an annotation ninja, equipped with the power of Monster Insights and GA4 annotations. But wait, there's still more. Using Google Analytics annotations isn't just about adding pretty notes to your website's timeline. It's about gaining insights, making data-driven decisions, and growing your business faster. With Monster Insights Site Notes, you can effortlessly keep your entire team on the same page, track the impact of your activities, and optimize your website's performance like a pro. So So what are you waiting for? It's time to level up your Google Analytics game and start adding those awesome GA4 annotations. Download Monster Insights, grab a cup of coffee or tea, if that's your thing, and let the annotation adventure begin. And that's all for today, folks. I hope that you enjoyed this deep dive into GA4 annotations with Monster Insights. If you found the video helpful, give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button. I'll see you next time.